Hello, you beautiful people, and welcome back to Let's Play Terminator. Okay, we have an entrance into the factory. I am not certain if I'm supposed to go into the factory right now. So I am gonna leave the factory behind here in the hope that I am gonna remember the factory at a later stage, which I might forget, but we don't have a order to get there. As of yet, which is for me just fine. I wonder if the energy cells are actually blocked from the other side. If the energy cells are used for... Okay, good. If the energy cells are used for laser weaponry, and I wonder if laser weaponry is gonna be the key against them Terminators. Don't know. We'll find out. On the best part here, obviously, okay, that's a lot of ammunition. Feeling good, until we find out that it's not that much. I wanted to say that saved us obviously ammunition, and that is what I think is good. On the other hand, it is good that the light, the flashlight, is not using up a battery. That would make the game even harder to go through, in my opinion. Okay, a new skill point. That is quite great. Take all. And this is now actually what is good here. We can actually take a quick look until after I've opened that up. We can take a quick look in the skills tree. So we could... This is of course good as well. We are level 3, right? The next level upgrade is going to be at level 6 plus more. No, 25%. Oh. That's insane, right? With standard weapons and not laser weapons, but we could go into lockpicking. That's where I think I'm going, since this is level 6. And the important part is gonna be at level 24, where we receive health regeneration. So my thought is now between experience. I think I'm gonna go with experience for now. Why? Because 10% from 100 is... from 1,000 is 100, right? That is, in my opinion, quite the good... quite a good trade-off. So what I'm wondering... Yeah, are we actually able to save? We should be able to save right here, right? Open up. Bird of Prey. They came again. Ever since Skynet arrived in Pasadena, everyone's gotten more violent, desperate, and hungry. I don't know how long I'll be able to protect my babies, but I'll fight to the death if I have to. Well, yeah, especially if you have... With kids around, that is, I guess, where every parent, so to say, gets into this desperation mode, right? And... maybe even being more aggressive to save your kids. I guess that's normal to come, right? Game saved. And we are gonna take, not take, we need to go in this direction. So we might be able to actually do something for a quest in this episode. And this is what I don't mind, to be utterly honest. Mm-hmm. Okay, I for a second thought there was another robot incoming. I mean, yes, you see how much damage we do there, right? So I guess it is of utter importance to do the upgrades, which we saw there. Oh, hello, little droney buddy. And I really should heal. It somehow feels like a very, very hard survival game, in my opinion. At this beginning, well, we are still at the beginning, so that's all I can say here. We need to take them down, right? Them, I mean, this would make the game worse if they would be really a hard AI and able, you know, with image recognition to instantly see you. How was, I'm sorry, I gotta need to look something up again. What was actually closed melee attack? Was it L3? R3 it ain't. And so item, weapon, shoot, throw, heal, crouch, jump, reload, interact. Ah, melee attack, okay. Confusing world for me. It, again, I'm not complaining, but it looks all some way the same. That is what currently is a little bit throwing me off. This is, I mean, it's always the little things which make a game
alive.
What I wanted to say, there are always small things which make games hard or, well, not that hard. And how many, yes, you can argue if I would shoot better, then obviously it would, we would do more damage, yada yada yada. But we have quite, ammunition is a huge deal in this game. LA Pulse, Friday, August 29th, 1997, World News. When a spokesman for Russia's Ministry of Atomic Energy was asked about the origin of the seismic event that took place at the Russian nuclear test site 2 weeks ago, he responded by saying, "I don't know what seismic activity they are talking about. Russia has voluntarily discontinued any nuclear testing and has stuck to this decision." Well, would you believe Russia? I for sure would not. But 1997 were surely other times, right? Ten years after the fall of the wall, after Cold War, things were getting better, right? We were a better state than we are currently are. In 1997, Putin was not yet in power, right? That nasty boy. Okay, Kles. That's good, so that's done. It seems to be like we are gonna be able to loot something here, right? Are we?
Resistance?
Nah, it looked like a scavenger. We aren't too far from our new hideout. Maybe it's the guy who lives there. You know what? I think I'll introduce myself. The least I can do for leaving us all those resources? Shit. I might even give him a thank you card!
Okay, we are now gonna go back to our safe point.
You keep looking.
Since that is actually where we are gonna start over in the next episode, you guys. This is, I'm not yet certain, since we have no possibility of fast traveling, so that I'm not gonna be able to just fast travel there. And this is the starting point and the only point where we can save. So we are just gonna start over there, and then we are head over there. It's, you know, closer than this one. Then we can fight over here, actually go back there and have some fun, right? Since everything's actually killed here, all is fine. And that, you guys, right now brings us to the end of this episode. And you know it, I, as usual, really, there's a drone there, which we might take down in the next episode. Thank you for watching. If you guys actually do have enjoyed this episode, then please give me a little thumbs up and subscribe. And hopefully I see you in the next episode. Until then, have a wonderful day. Stay frosty. Bye.